Hello, and welcome to an overview of how your SoulCollage deck can help you unlock the tremendous potential that you hold within. I am Audrey Chowdhury, an art therapist and SoulCollage trainer and facilitator. I've facilitated workshops and consultations using SoulCollage cards in a wide variety of settings with many populations. And I have found that SoulCollage offers an amazingly effective portal to the internal energy, wisdom, and guidance that waits to be invited into our lives if we are willing to use the keys of intuition and imagination. Maybe you've explored ways to get to know your true self through self-help books or therapy or astrology or the Enneagram or by taking personality inventory tests, etc. Well, your deck can give you all the information you need and can enhance your experience of these other tools. I am a trauma survivor. I wasn't aware of how this was affecting me until I was a young mother and started having flashbacks. The terror, shame, and anger just seemed to come up without warning. These feelings were probably triggered by having young kids of my own. I was fortunate to have a very good therapist who explained that these feelings belonged to parts of me who had been around for a long time and were now feeling safe enough to show up and demand some attention. I was able to create a picture of my inner world, but I did not know how to integrate these parts in a way that would help all of these energies feel that they were seen and heard. Some of these parts were self-destructive and needed to be seen and accepted, but they also needed to be contained in a safe way. I worked through this process of self-discovery with a very capable, wise psychotherapist and an art therapist. It was a fascinating process that eventually healed the flashbacks and allowed me to function as a healthy adult mother of two. This healing art process was so profoundly effective that I eventually felt called to pursue my master's degree in art therapy. I found the SoulCollage book at an art therapy conference in 2001. This book spoke to my very core. I saw how Seena Frost had developed a system and structure that could help someone like me. What excited me most was this process not only outlined a simple and powerful way for the parts of oneself to be seen and heard, but it also outlined a way for these parts to begin to integrate and form a cohesive, balanced, functioning whole. I have never stopped using SoulCollage in my personal and professional work. I see how the sheer genius of the process is in the structure of the suits. They have given me and my clients a way to understand myself and all of my inner workings. Many people don't want to put their cards in suits. I like my cards just the way they are. Why do I need to put them in a category? In her book, SoulCollage Evolving, Seena Frost writes, "Let me just say that there is a real value in using the suit structure and having the cards identified on their backs. The suits help you stretch to look for and recognize netters that are working in and through you, ones that you might never have noticed or named. It helps you recognize what is local story and what is larger story in your personal life story, and how these two mix and merge and manifest. Giving your cards a home in a suit is a way to achieve some degree of integration. If you look at the word integration, you find that the root is integrity, and integrity is honesty. It is integratedness. It is walking your talk. When you have the courage to act in accordance with your values and beliefs, your inner parts are working together. When you are in integrity, you can feel that you are speaking the truth and acting out of your authentic self with focus and clarity. Your soul's energetic signature is evident in your deck. Your cards, especially the ones you made without intention, the ones that seemed to create themselves, are a direct expression of your authentic self. Each card represents an energy living inside of you. These are pieces of yourself that dared to show up, wanted to be seen, and chose to be visible. It is very important to remember this. These are living, breathing energies living inside of you. Some may have been with you since childhood. These parts may have been buried because they don't fit in with your persona that you choose to present. The danger of ignoring these parts is they can make you ill, or they can make you feel crazy or confused, or they can cause you to act impulsively or in a self-destructive or ineffective way. We all think we know what we are doing. We have a plan. But some part of us may have other plans, and they will find a way to get what they want. If we don't act on their desire or acknowledge it, it doesn't go away. We may get a headache. We may feel frustrated or depressed. We don't have to act on every desire of every netter, but when they feel recognized and heard, the desire won't be as disruptive to your life. When you create a soul collage card, you are breathing life into this part of you. This energy does not want to be kept in a box again. This part of you has announced itself as an important player in your life. Your deck is like a jigsaw puzzle. It is a collection of pictures of facets of yourself, showing up for you to see and know them. Now, this can be wonderful at first, when you are enamored of these long-lost parts of yourself coming back to life. But after you've created a number of cards, this can quickly become overwhelming. How can you see how they relate to each other? How can all of these separate cards or pieces come together to create a cohesive self-portrait? Putting your cards in suits helps you to become aware of the relationships of your netters and allows you to recognize your inner dramas. Understanding the relationships and group dynamics of your inner world is key to achieving inner peace and harmony. For example, you may become aware that some of your netters or pieces of your puzzle like to hide, and some have an agenda and will work by subverting themselves, working through others like high school intrigue and manipulation. Now, this dynamic can happen unconsciously if you don't have an idea of the structure of your inner pieces. Council netters provide you with the inspiration, the wisdom, and the intuition you need to make wise choices as you play the game of life. Council cards are energy, fuel, and resources for us to use. But we don't remember to use them because the ego parts think they are alone and in charge. The companions provide you with the energy, drive, and instincts you need to succeed. Companions are tremendous instinctual energy and power that we don't use when we are not aware it is there for us. These parts of you remember that you are more than a body and personality, and that you really don't have control over most of the challenges that will occur during the game of life. Committee and community energies often think that they have no energy to draw from. Another way to think of this is to imagine that the council and companion netters are your fuel, and committee and community are your vehicles. We all want to be co-creators in this world of ours, and when each part becomes aware of this, our inner life can shift from conflicting drives to a drive to see how the inner parts can play together as a team. Your soul collage suits give you the scaffolding upon which to create the bigger picture. One piece at a time is how this happens. That is why I am so excited about helping you give structure and meaning to your collection of soul collage cards. I know that doing this can impact your life in profound and subtle ways. There are 5 suits in the Soul Collage deck: the Council, Companions, Committee, Community, and 3 transpersonal cards. Imagine the shape of a cross with a circle at each end of the vertical line and a circle at each end of the horizontal line, with a circle in the center where they all come together. You can think of the vertical line as the conduit to the eternal aspects of ourself. The horizontal line is the conduit to the temporal aspects of ourselves. The suits are arranged so that the council suit is found in the circle at the top of the vertical line. The companion suit is found in the circle at the foot of the vertical line. And the committee suit is found in the circle on one end of the horizontal line, and the community suit on the other end of the horizontal line. You will notice that at each end of the vertical line, you find the suits that represent those aspects of your being that are directly connected to your divinity, or soul, or higher self, however you might think of those parts that were here before you and will be here after you die. The council on top, representing the larger versions of yourself, those parts that seem to speak from above, and the companions on bottom, connecting you to the eternal aspects of the earth and nature. These two suits on the vertical line represent your essential qualities that are striving to express through you and your many facets. Now look at the horizontal line, and you will notice that the parts of you that represent your present personality and your life on the earth at this time are on each end. The committee suit represents those parts of you that form your personality and that have adapted to the various roles you play in your daily life. The community suit represents sentient beings, whether they are people, pets, trees, or places that have meaning and importance to you either now or in your past. Your family members, your teachers, role models, friends, even your dog or cat may be found in the community suit. The horizontal line is where you play out your daily life. These two suits represent the parts of you that have the potential to express your essential qualities. Your personal traits, roles, relationships, and desires show themselves in the two suits that anchor the horizontal line. Those forces that influence your being through inspiration, intuition, and instinct show themselves in the two suits that anchor the vertical line. The energies of these four suits meet in the heart, and this is where your soul essence resides. It may help to think of these four suits in this way. Your inspired qualities come from the council. In other words, your council cards are your inspiration. Your innate qualities reside in the companions. Your companion cards express your particular inner energies. Your expression and experience of these qualities reside in your committee and community. Your committee cards are influenced, most of the time unconsciously, by these inspirations and innate drives in all that they think, say, do, and feel. Your community members are reflections of the influence that these inspirations and innate drives have on the relationships that you have with people, animals, places, and culture. It is interesting to note that most of us live our lives along the horizontal line, forgetting the vast reservoir of expansive qualities along the vertical line that are waiting to be expressed through us. The fifth suit is the transpersonal suit, encircling the entire cross diagram. Connecting and embracing all of the suits is the source. This is the primary transpersonal card, and it represents the mystery of oneness that underlies all that is. It represents the source of all that ever was, is, and will be. Source might also be called spirit. The circle where the two lines intersect at the heart is where the soul essence is found. And this is where one's unique essence or spark of source within the soul comes alive in our present self. In the words of Seena Frost, one's soul essence is the quintessentialness of a being. It is ever-present and immortal. Another circle intersects the soul essence, and this is where the witness, the third of the transpersonal cards, resides. This is the part that allows one to move away from identifying with the smaller personality selves and begin to see the bigger picture of the self as a many-faceted entity. It is the all-seeing eye of consciousness. If you are new to SoulCollage, I hope that this program will inspire and encourage you to think about the suits your new cards could belong to from the beginning.